constantly find myself brooding and anticipating whether I was capable of achieving the goals that I had in mind. From being a person who would continuously doubt herself to becoming a person who aspires to achieve the highest standard possible at any task, regardless of the obstacles, was the route that I had to take. My father was ailing during one of the most important academic years of my life. There was stress, there was apprehension concerning my studies and due to the dire circumstances at home. Nevertheless, with the efforts of my father and with the intent to revamp my attitude towards the situation is what helped me realize that I could conquer insurmountable heights. From being a person or being an introvert and a silent child to becoming an extrovert with confidence, my doubts and insecurities ranged from my abilities to perform well to the way I looked. And even now, at times, I find myself thinking about the same things that deterred me to move forward and ahead earlier. But as soon as I'm reminded of all the good things that have come my way and all the achievements that had changed me as a person with growth potential, I put myself in a better place. And all these years, I realized that all I needed was a little push to tap my potential. And during the course of my scholastic journey, I had an entourage of mentors that also comprised my teachers, my parents, my friends, my peers, and all those who surrounded me. And under their guidance and support, I was driven to prioritize my work and comprehend as well as address my emotions through the peaks and troughs, whilst I was also able to generate outcomes with the hard work that I had put in. So other than academics, I would also like to lay emphasis on the need to try out new opportunities and ventures. Such chances and events broaden our outlook and horizons towards the world. And they also cultivate our personalities so as to explore varied fields and take them up with diligence. The opportunities that come your way play a major role in shaping how we carry ourselves in the greater world, because it takes a lot to explore different things. But once you start to get the hang of it, you also gain the power to explore more and, of course, to feed your curiosity about the world and about how things work. So since I was a kid, I have been fond of reading. I identify myself as an avid reader. And I absolutely love and enjoy exploring the depths of psychology as a discipline and as a philosophy. And I would say that as a result of my reading habit, I always ensure that I remain in learning mode and gain new knowledge every day. This is something that has perhaps also played an upper hand in placing my faith in myself, while also allowing me to give myself the opportunity to explore the world through the eyes of different writers, scholars, and intellectuals. So now, through all these learnings and through all that I had experienced, I see myself as a strong and confident person with the gist to persevere. And there is one more thing that I would like to add. It is important to accept criticism in a positive light. While I realize that it takes immense amount of effort and courage to do so, it is also an ongoing process. Because in the eyes of people, we may never level up to their standards. But that is not as important as it is to realize that we can always and always find a way to work on the aspects of our personality that hold us back to perform certain tasks or to take up new challenges. And moreover, it is also important to learn from those around us. Everybody has something or some insight and knowledge to offer, and taking this particular view into account, there is so much that we can take as a learning to move ahead in life. In hindsight, I believe that gaining a clarity of goals and by knowing my options to by prioritizing those specific goals with tools of time and priority management, it kind of had an important and colossal role to play in the enhancement of my performance during the high school years. I'd dissociated with negative emotions, and I would take the responsibility of challenging all the obstacles that came in the way. I disengaged from unhealthy peer pressure, and that largely comprised rivalry and deteriorative competition, which is not healthy to proceed and excel. Moreover, reinforcing and pumping a daily dose of motivation through engagement with my entourage and, of course, with my own mind and self, I'd built a robust foundation for myself to excel. It facilitated my progression in following a repetitive process that drove me to successfully achieve my goals. And by the end of my last year in high school, I'd received great scores for my performance and for the hard work that I'd put in. And in the year of 2018, I joined the sociology department at the Lady Shri Ram College for Women. It was one of my biggest achievements post high school, and I was extremely excited and grateful to have had the opportunity to join an institution of prestige and honor with so many achievers. The magic of LSR has done wonders for me, and I gained a lot more confidence and resilience to excel and to achieve every task at hand. Till date, LSR drives me to move forward, to constantly test my abilities as to how they should be worked upon, and in order to, of course, grow and learn from each and every individual that I've ever come across. Although due to the exceptionally high standards of performance, of achievement, of work, at times you feel like you're falling short on one thing or another. Yet it also imparts a great amount of power to scrutinize your thoughts, actions, and decisions in a direction of achievement. So all these events had a huge role to play in my success, and they drove me to pursue tasks that seemed far-fetched in the beginning. And I would also like to add that ultimately I realized that my concerns and worries are not unique. It's not like these thoughts were entirely concerned with me. Each and every person that I've come across, and the anticipation of what would happen next, was common to all. As a result of the drive that was instilled in me, my fellow friends and I decided upon effectuating a course for students like ourselves, which preceded the genesis of Mentor Mitra, which was again followed by inculcating a robust framework for working professionals as well. And as I was following the process and format that my mentors, my entourage, had laid for me, I could assimilate the diverse tools that were deployed by us all together. And I recommended the process to a lot of my school and college friends, as well as to my juniors. And everybody who had implemented it achieved success, as the process had been predictable in terms of generating outcomes. And of course, there's something that I'd like to add to this. Your achievements take a lead when you set the right intent, and of course the intent to achieve, to start from zero, to rise above your circumstances and to unleash your own potential. So my endeavor now is to provide continuous support to students, people, my juniors, and anybody I can counsel and lend them a helping hand while they grow in their journey of career development. The very fact that we are humans implies that we have countless capabilities, and we can stretch to any extent and explore diverse dimensions, or perhaps master the so-called insurmountable goals whilst we gain different experiences and pick up new skills as we proceed. So I firmly believe that a high level of commitment with a sturdy magnitude of emotional intelligence sequentially dwindles the impact of failure, because dejection can be defeated, fears can be overcome, and the doubts that exist in our minds can be overhauled. This is the course and knowledge that I objectively wish to disseminate and instill in individuals who doubt their capacity and resilience to excel, just like I did in my school years, or I still do. And that's something I find myself persistently working on. So a huge thanks to all of you for having me here, for hearing me out, for listening to my experiences and achievements. I hope there is something that you have to take away from this.